is the steadily emerging Hibs facing the faltering but undoubtedly talented Celtic, with Hibs playing down the Easter Road slope in the first half with the benefit of a very strong wind behind. Here's Andy Walker and Morris. Morris again, there's McAvenny, beaten away by Gorham, and that was superb goalkeeping by Andy Gorham. Enormous kick out from Gorham. There's Evans. Evans and Archibald almost combining to double on run. Billy. Enormous touched it in the air. Here's Frank McAvenny with a great chance for Celtic. The tackle came from Sneddon and the referee waves play on. The Celtic players are incensed. Fierce appeals for a penalty kick. Celtic trying to get forward again. There's Archibald, who's also anxious moments for Tommy Craig and Billy McNeil in the Celtic dugout. Morris with the cross, an awkward one for Gorham. A very confident piece of handling once again. Aiken judging the high ball well, but here's Eddie May, and that's towards Archibald. He's in behind Bailey. The chance is on for Hibs! Steve Archibald! His first league goal for Hibs, coming in the 13th minute. Finishing of the highest caliber. Hibs have another corner kick. All these set pieces potentially menacing with the wind swirling in on Alan Ruff. Played in by Eddie May. There's Archibald! Steve Archibald gets his second. 19 minutes on the clock. It's a brilliant start by Hibs. Brilliantly taken down by McStay. Well, they're running it though and allowing Eddie May to step in. These are a fine start to the match for Hibs, the youngster in midfield. And a great effort from May. Alan Ruff looking the calmest.
Away from May.
McStay takes over. That's one for Walker to chase inside the box. The early cross, missed by everyone, there's John Crane on it, Milne clears it up, McAvenny turned it across, it's off the line by Sneddon, the Hibs goal leading a charmed life as Celtic still probe for the opening. Here's McStay, now Morris, up goes Rogan, he mistouched the flight of the ball, it's Evans who goes back to defend and the tackle from Burns turned it out. Well, a charmed life indeed for Hibs. With all that activity around Andy Gorham. There's Evans taken out of the play by Aiken. Body check by Roy Aiken on the flying Gareth Evans, and that'll be a booking for the Celtic captain. They're in by Orr. This is Archibald with the dummy and Ray with the miscue. The spin cutting the ball across. There's Evans! 3-0 to Hibs! 5 minutes from half-time, a disaster for Celtic defensively. In the form of three Hibs goals. Here goes the half-time whistle. But that first half was a triumph for Steve Archibald, the Scottish international, repaying Alec Miller's faith with two magnificent pieces of striking early on. The first, a left-foot shot drilled beyond Alan Ruff, then a glancing header, then it was Gareth Evans who stepped in, picking up the confusion created by Archibald's dummy inside the box to make the half-time score one which will scarcely be believed across the country. It's Hibs 3, Celtic 0. Celtic now have the benefits of the elements. There's Orr and Kane. Evans returning it to Archibald. Aiken's challenge. Here's Kane again. Here's Steve Archibald. The looping shot from Archibald. Alan Ruff with a fine save. Next day to Walker. He takes the return. That's from McAvenny. Great chance for Celtic. Gorham, and it's nodded down by Andy Walker. Celtic get a goal back. Trying to get the ball retrieved as quickly as possible. 10 minutes gone in the second half. Well, Evans, tireless working up front, restless, brave forward. Archibald to Collins, great play from Collins, beaten away by Ruff. Oh, fine inventive play once again.
Score twice.
Derek White coming up with Lex Bailey. Gorham drops it under pressure, it's chopped off, it won't count. Frustration on the face of Roy Aiken. Mike McGinley, and no doubt, on the spot. No joy for Roy Aiken. There's Milne. Archibald nudging it towards Evans. It's Evans now, he's through for Hibs for the start of the fourth goal, perhaps. Blocked well, but just wait for the applause for Archibald. Standing ovation from the Hibs fans, and he goes off after taking that knock on the right knee. Saluting the Hibs fans. His first half performance was electric. Congratulated by the manager, Alec Miller. The young Joe Tortolano goes on. All Hibs fans' eyes on referee Mike McGinley, and there goes the final whistle. Famous victory for him. The triumph, though, down to Steve Archibald in particular, who inspired him with a magnificent start to the match. Hibs defence did its job in the second half with only that Andy Walker goal 10 minutes into the second half to show for Celtic's effort. So the final score is Hibs 3, Celtic 1.